Hello and welcome to the new session on fluid mechanics. Since we had discussed about the simple manometers, in the simple manometer, if you remember, I had told you that there are three types. One is piezometer, second one is U-tube manometer, and the third one is single column manometer. Single column manometer. This is the slightly different version of a manometer. Though the shape is U-tube only, now you can observe that in case of a single column manometer, you will have a reservoir introduced into the left limb. Reservoir is nothing but a bigger section in the left limb than the usual U-tube diameter. So what actually happens in that case, you know that it works on no change in the volume of the manometric liquid. Since there will be no change in the volume of manometric liquid and the area of both the limbs, height variation had to be equal in both the limbs. Whereas now, since you introduce a reservoir in one of the limbs, reservoir will have at least 100 times bigger diameter than the actual limb diameter. So what actually happens is, for a very slight variation in one limb, there will be huge variation in the another limb. This will happen because the volume has to be equal. That means for the same volume, because the area is high in one end, the height will be less. Whereas for the same volume to move upwards in the other limb, the height required will be very high because area will be too small. Based on this concept, it is very simple to measure the pressure at a given point, because you need not have to measure what is the value at the left limb, and you can straight away measure the height of variation in the right limb, which will directly give you the pressure at the required point. That is the reason why the single column manometer is introduced. And in single column manometer, you have two types. One is vertical single column manometer and the other one is inclined single column manometer. First, I will take up the vertical single column manometer. So first, I will first draw how actually the single column manometer look like. This is what I meant by a reservoir. In the glass tube itself, you introduce a large chamber. I will first keep it empty, then I will help you with the complete diagram. Now this is actually the manometric setup. The right limb is having the diameter of the glass tube, whereas the left limb, in between you have a large chamber, say a glass chamber. This is said to be reservoir in comparison to the dimension of the limb. So now when I pour the manometric liquid inside, what will happen? By virtue of pressures being same on either ends, because both the ends are open to atmosphere, there has to be level in the two limbs. That's what I'll show you now. Let us assume this is the level to which you have the manometric liquid. So this is the manometric arrangement. When you pour manometric liquid into the single column manometer, this is how the level is formed. Now when I attach this to point where pressure is to be measured, say positive gauge pressure. Positive gauge pressure means pressure at A is greater than the atmospheric pressure. As we all know, when there is excess pressure in this point, the manometric liquid has to be pushed downwards. So what actually happens is, now this liquid will push this manometric liquid for a very slight depth because of the great volume. Now only for this volume that has come down in the left limb, there will be a huge rise in the right limb, say up to this point. That is very, very important in this case. Since the volume cannot change and area has changed, height has to change. In all the previous cases that we have discussed, height did not change because volume and area were same. Now, volume of liquid cannot change, however, area has changed. So, for the slightest of variation, say delta H in the left limb, there is a huge variation in the right limb. Now, I'll try to give the names to all these things prior to changing, let the height be equal to H1, and after the change, let the height be equal to H2, and the change in the left wing, left limb be equal to delta H. Now, when I write the gauge equation to this system, how will that look like? So, starting from one end, that is pressure at A, say PA converted to head of water becomes HA. Let this be with a specific gravity as usual, S1, rho 1, density and specific weight of gamma 1, and the manometric liquid be with specific gravity SM, density rho M and specific weight gamma M. Now, in the left limb, starting from the left limb, I have HA as the pressure at this point. Coming downwards, it has to be positive. What is the liquid specific gravity here? S1 into how much is the height? Height up to this point is H1, and there is further variation of delta H. So, it is S1 into H1 plus delta H, and this forms the new datum line. Now, this forms the datum line. What is the meaning of datum line? The horizontal line below which in both the limbs you will have same liquid for same height. That line is YY here. From here onwards, this is the datum line. So, from here to here below YY, there is same liquid for same height. That means there is no pressure variation. I will neglect that part. Moving upwards, what will we have? Moving upwards is minus S2 or SM is the specific gravity of the manometric liquid. SM into delta H plus H2. This must be equal to 0. But in this, the entire equation, you can observe that you wanted to find out HA. So, HA is equal to delta H can be taken outside. You have S1H1 minus SMH2. So, what is this delta H? Delta H, now if you observe, since the volume in both the limbs has to be same. What is the volume in both the limbs? Assume that the area of the reservoir that you have considered is A. Area of reservoir is equal to capital A. Now, area of limb, be equal to small letter A. Since the volumes have to be equal, that means delta H into capital A. So, if you observe, delta H is the small variation in height because of manometric deflection multiplied by the cross-sectional area A. This must be equal to, I will write prior to this line, since volume of manometric liquid remains same, delta H into A in the left limb must be equal to, if you observe what has changed here, H2 is the variation, H2 into small letter A. That means what actually is delta H? Delta H is nothing but small letter A by capital letter A into H2. So, I will replace this in the given equation or the deduced equation. Therefore, HA is equal to, in place of delta H, it is A by A into H2 multiplied by S1 H1 minus SM H2. Since this ratio A by A will be very, very, very small, Why? Because the area of the reservoir will be at least 100 times bigger than this. So this can be neglected, and hence you have the value straight away calculated only using this and the previously known H1. Even prior to starting the experiment, you know, you knew what was H1. Now after the experiment, if you just measure what is H2, you can easily find out what is the pressure at the given point. That is nothing but HA is equal to S1 H1 minus SM H2. So this is how you can solve easily using the single column manometer. To convert this into pressure, PA is equal to, you have to multiply HA by specific weight of water, that is rho W into G into HA. This is the expression. Now I had told you that there are two types of single column manometer. One is vertical single column manometer. The next one has to be the inclined single column manometer. I'll retain the left hand side as it is, but I'll change the right hand side to an inclined one. So there is an inclination, but rest of the things remain same. So it has to form the level. I will draw that. First it was at this level. So I will take this up to this level in the inclined also. One very important concept that you will have to understand through inclined column manometer is we are interested only in the vertical height. Only that is called head, not the inclined height. That you will have to be very, very sure prior to starting this derivation. Now, once there is manometric deflection, because pressure at this point is greater than atmospheric pressure. So this liquid pushes the manometric liquid. Since the volume is too high or the area is too high here, the deflection will be very small. Whereas for the same deflection here, you will have a greater deflection in height. And let the angle of inclination be equal to theta. Let the angle of inclination be equal to theta. What I actually want is this H2, which is nothing but head difference. Now the new deflection because of the pressure variation. Let me take the inclined length as L. So by using our basic trigonometrical knowledge, if you can find out what is H2 in terms of L, because H2 cannot be straight away measured, but L can be measured, that is nothing but length of the inclined portion above after the deflection, that can easily be found out. So you must know what actually L is. Using that, you will have to find H2. Can you give me what is the relationship between H2, L and theta? For that, I'll take another simple drawing. So this arrangement looks very similar to this. This part is nothing but H2, this part is L, and this angle is theta. From this triangle, what are the things known to you? Opposite side is known, hypotenuse is known. What connects opposite and hypotenuse? It is sine. Therefore you can write sine theta is equal to sin theta is equal to opposite by hypotenuse, that is H2 by L. What we actually want is H2. Therefore you can write H2 is equal to L sin theta. H2 is equal to L sin theta. Rest of the things will remain same except the value of H2 in this equation. In place of H2, you will write it as L sin theta and conclude the problem, conclude the derivation. So I'll retain all these things as it is. I'll remove it. So only thing I am going to write here is the final equation. HA is equal to S1 H1 minus SM H2 can be written as S1 H1 minus SM. In place of H2, I will write L sin theta, and PA is easily achieved. This is the concept of single column manometer, vertical as well as inclined. We have had an elaborate discussion on how manometer is used to measure the pressure at a point in the fluid. Now, if you have to measure the difference of pressure between two points in the same fluid or difference of pressure between two points in two different fluids, what we have to do and how we will have to make use of the manometer is today's quest. Now, when you used piezometer or simple U-tube manometer, you connected one point where pressure was to be measured and you let the other part open to atmosphere. Whereas, when you have to measure the difference of pressure between two points in the same pipeline or in two different pipelines, you will have to make use of differential U-tube manometer. Differential U-tube manometer. The definition of differential U-tube manometer slightly differs from that of the simple U-tube manometer. In case of differential U-tube manometer, two limbs of the manometers are connected to points where pressure is to be measured or pressure difference needs to be measured, and there will be deflection of manometric fluid based on the pressure at those two points, and you can easily measure the difference of pressure. So I will straight away take up U-tube. You know that I have drawn at least two manometers yesterday or in the previous class. You will now understand, since both the limbs of the manometers are open to atmosphere, pressure are same. Since the pressure are same, pressure heads are also have to be same. In that case, once you start pouring a manometric liquid into this, that will form the same level in both the limbs. I will consider manometric liquid to be full and up to this level in both the limbs. So I would take a heavier liquid in the manometer and now connect that to two points where pressure is to be measured. Assume that this point is A and let it contain a liquid of say specific gravity S1, density rho 1, specific weight gamma 1. And now you know that first it will be at level, and when you connect this to two points where pressure is to be measured, how the deflection takes place, let us discuss now. Now I will connect this to other point, say B, containing another liquid, say of specific gravity S2, density rho 2, and specific weight gamma 2. Now, assuming that pressure at A is greater than pressure at B, you can as well assume pressure at B to be greater than pressure at A, but for the time being, I will consider pressure at A to be greater than pressure at B. Now, I had shown you a tube yesterday. You remember or you recall that arrangement. Now, if the pressure at A is greater than pressure at B, let us now focus on what actually happens. If pressure at A is greater, it will tend to push the manometric liquid downwards. And if the pressure at B is less than that at A, this limb will have to accept the rise of fluid. Since the volume of fluid is not going to change and area of both the limbs are same, volume means area into height. Since volume and area are not going to change, height has to be same. That means to say, the height of fall in the left limb must be equal to height of rise in the right limb. Now, I will try to depict that. Now, I have told you that pressure at A is greater than pressure at B is the case that we have taken. And I have told you how to write the gauge equation. Convert all the pressures into heads of water. How do we do that? Just by dividing the given pressure by specific weight of water. This means to say HA is greater than HB. So what does that make? This will make the manometric liquid go down by some depth. And for the same depth, there shall be rise in the manometric liquid in the right limb, and I will also show that using this. Now this is the manometric arrangement after the deflection. What has happened now? I'll because you have pressure at A to be greater than pressure at B, the liquid at A has pushed the manometric liquid by some height. For the same height, there is rise in the right limb. Now this is the manometric arrangement for which you will have to calculate what is actually the pressure difference between A and B. So next step would be to draw the datum line. What is the datum line? Datum line is a horizontal line across the manometric system below which in both the limbs you have the same liquid. I have chosen this point because below this line, if you draw the line below that line, you have same liquid in both the limbs for same height. And on the horizontal line, you must know that pressure will remain the same on both the limbs. That means pressure above YY in the left limb must be equal to pressure above YY in the right limb. And to start to write the gauge equation, you know the steps. Convert all the pressures, even the required pressures, to head of water. That's what I have written, HA and HB. Starting from one end, move towards the other end. So starting from left hand side, HA, move towards the other end. So first you have the horizontal part. In the horizontal direction, there is no variation in pressure. And when you come down, you have, say, liquid of specific gravity S1 for a height of H1. So in the downward direction, pressure increases. So plus S1, H1. And YY is the datum line. So below YY in both the limbs, there is no pressure variation. So you can leave out this part of the manometric system. And moving upwards, you have, this is the manometric liquid with specific gravity SM, density rho M, specific weight gamma M. Let the height of the manometric liquid or heavier liquid be equal to HM, and from the center of pipe B to this, let the height be equal to H2. So above this line, you have two different liquids. Going upwards, you will have to take negative. Negative, what is the specific gravity of this manometric liquid? SM. SM for a height of HM. Still going upwards, you have minus. Specific gravity of this liquid is S2 for a height of H2 minus HB. That is, pressure at B converted to head at B must be equal to 0. Now we needed to find out the difference of pressure between A and B. So I will keep HA minus HB in the left hand side. This must be equal to SM HM plus S2 H2 minus S1 H1. Now if you observe this, you have already solved the problem. But what is the requirement? You needed to find out the difference in pressure. What you have found out is difference in pressure heads. So how do we calculate pressure difference? PA minus PB must be equal to whatever you have as HA minus HB multiplied by rho into G. Rho W, that is density of water into G. This gives you the difference between two points, the pressure difference between two points using differential U-tube manometers. The example that I have chosen is two fluids at different levels. Now you can also take an example of the two points, pressure difference between two points which are at the same level. That also can be done. If you have understood this, I will clear this off and go with that. Now when you have pressure to be measured, the pressure difference to be measured in a pipe at the same level, there is no much difference. That's why I have written the same diagram. Again, I will consider S1, rho 1 and gamma 1 to be the properties of liquid in pipe A, and let again PA be greater than PB, HA greater than HB. The only difference I will have to make is, now if the pressure at A is greater, that means the liquid will push the manometric liquid, and let the height of liquid be H1, and the manometric deflection will be as shown in the figure. Now you can observe the same equation can be used to find out the pressure difference between two points even though they are at the same level. I recommend you not to remember any of the equations while going to exam or even for solving any numerical problems. Do not remember any equation, but understand the gauge equation, the process of writing the gauge equation, and you will never go wrong and things will be very, very simple. I will solve a lot of numerical problems on this, which will definitely help you, and you can write the gauge equation on your own and you can draw the solutions. Before I get into numerical problems, I am left with one simple concept, that is inverted U-tube manometer. So now what we have learnt is two types of U-tube manometers. One is simple and the differential. In case of simple manometers, you have learnt two things again. One for measuring positive gauge pressure, other for measuring vacuum pressure. And in case of U-tube manometer, which is differential U-tube manometer, one manometer to find difference of pressure between two points which are at different levels. Now we have also solved that for finding out the pressure at two points at the same level. Now we'll go to inverted U-tube differential manometer. The concept remains the same, but two things that you must remember when you work with the inverted U-tube manometer is about the manometric liquid. In case of U-tube manometer, the manometric liquid had to be a liquid which is heavier than the liquid whose pressure was to be measured, or specific gravity of the manometric liquid must be greater than the liquid whose pressure was to be measured. But in case of inclined manometer, in case of inverted manometer, you must remember that the specific gravity of the manometric liquid should be less than the liquid whose pressure is to be measured. That means if you are going to measure the pressure of water, then you will have to have a liquid which is having less specific gravity than water as manometric liquid. See, inverted U-tube manometers are used to measure low pressure differences, whereas these U-tube manometers, regular U-tube manometers, are used to measure greater pressure differences. So I will now take up the inverted U-tube manometer. So first, as usual, I will have to draw a U-tube, but in the inverted manner. So they are connected to differential manometer, means both the ends have to be connected to points where pressure needs to be measured. Assume that this is A, this is B. Now when you take manometric liquid which is lighter than the liquids whose pressure or pressure difference are to be measured, now the pressure at A here, assume that this pushes the manometric liquid from here up to here. That means I'll remove this part. Why? Because of the pressure here, the level of manometric liquid is raised in the left limb, and symmetrically it has to fall in the right limb. So why? Because volume of the manometric liquid is not changing and area of the limbs are not different, hence height must be same. So this liquid moves up to this level, and let me call this as H1. This liquid be of specific gravity S1, density rho 1, specific weight gamma 1. This is the manometric liquid with specific gravity Sm, density rho m, and specific weight gamma m, and you have that for a height of, I'll take this as the datum line y. So below that datum you have manometric liquid for height hm and other liquid for height h2, and let this be of specific gravity s2, density rho 2, and specific weight gamma 2. In the same fashion as I have written the gauge equation for the previous cases, I can easily write the gauge equation here. Now, pressure at A converted into head of water at A becomes HA. In the horizontal direction, no variation. Going upwards, you have negative S1, H1. Again, only change you must remember, I had told you, you must remember two changes. One change was that the manometric liquid should be lighter than the liquid whose pressure is to be measured. The other point you must remember is the pressure below the datum line in the left limb is equal to pressure below the datum line in the right limb, whereas for previous cases it was pressure above the datum line in the left limb being equal to pressure above the datum line in the right limb. Now it is inverted, because this is also inverted U-tube manometer. The rule is inverted, and you can say that pressure below the datum YY in the left limb must be equal to pressure below the datum YY in the right limb. On that note, I am moving, starting from one end, moving to the other end. Now, coming downwards is positive SM, HM. Still coming downwards, you have S2, H2 and minus HB is equal to 0. You had to find out the pressure difference, that is HA minus HB is equal to S1, H1 minus SM, HM minus S2, H2. And you needed to find out the difference in pressure. So what do I do? PA minus PB. So this is nothing but head difference, HA minus HB. You want pressure difference. So multiply head difference by specific weight of water. What is specific weight of water? Rho W into G multiplied by HA minus HB. This is the equation to find out the pressure. That completes the theory part of the manometers. In the coming classes, we can take up numerical problems and we can better understand the concepts of pressure measurement. Thanks for patient listening. Good day.